Life of St. Nicholas the Wonderworker, retold for children. St. Nicholas the Wonderworker, Archbishop of Myra in Lycia, was born in Patara, Lycia, Asia Minor, to Theophanes and Nonna, who dedicated him to God. From birth, he showed his future glory. He stood in the baptismal font for 3 hours by himself, and he had no mother's milk on fast days until his parents finished evening prayers. He studied scripture all day in church and prayed all night. He was a worthy dwelling for the Holy Spirit. His uncle, Bishop Nicholas, rejoiced in Nicholas's piety. He ordained a reader, then a priest, and made him his assistant. Nicholas was like an elder, constantly at work and praying, displaying compassion as a youngster. He gave all his inheritance to the poor. There is a story of an impoverished man who had 3 grown daughters he planned to sell for money for food. Anonymously, St. Nicholas saved the family from spiritual ruin by throwing enough gold through the man's window to arrange honorable marriages for his daughters. One day, the Bishop of Patara took a pilgrimage to Jerusalem, entrusting the guidance of his flock to St. Nicholas while gone. Later, Nicholas went on the same journey. He predicted a storm would threaten the ship. He saw the devil board the boat to kill passengers. St. Nicholas calmed the waves by his prayers and healed an injured sailor who had fallen from the mast. He thanked the Savior and worshiped at all the holy places in Jerusalem. Nicholas desired to serve the Lord as an ascetic in the desert. However, God had a different plan for him. He heard a divine voice urging him to go home instead. Later, he entered Holy Sion Monastery, but the Lord said, "Nicholas, this is not the vineyard where you shall bear fruit for me. Return to the world and glorify my name there." So he went to Myra in Lycia. An elder had a vision after Archbishop John died, telling him the first to enter the church that night would be named Nicholas and be ordained an archbishop. When Nicholas arrived, the elder bishop asked, "What is your name, child?" Nicholas replied, "My name is Nicholas, Master, and I am your servant." Nicholas became Bishop of Myra and remained a great ascetic, gentle, kind, and loving. During the persecution of Christians under Emperor Diocletian, Bishop Nicholas was imprisoned with others and helped them endure. The Lord preserved him unharmed, and when Constantine became emperor, Nicholas was released. Saint Nicholas was a zealous warrior of the Church of Christ. Fighting evil, he went to pagan temples and shrines in Myra and nearby, shattering idols and turning temples to dust. In 325, Nicholas stood up against the heretic Arius at the First Ecumenical Council. Because he assailed Arius with words and struck him, he was stripped of rank and placed under guard. Several holy fathers shared a vision of the Lord and Mother of God returning the Gospel and Omophorion to Nicholas. They then agreed Nicholas's actions must have pleased God and restored him to the office of bishop. Throughout his life, Nicholas performed many miracles. Once, 3 men were unjustly condemned by the governor, who was bribed. Nicholas took away the executioner's sword, which was already over the heads of the condemned. The city of Myra was spared from famine when St. Nicholas appeared to an Italian merchant and left him 3 gold pieces to deliver grain there. Hearing the grief-filled prayers of parents who lost their only child in drowning, St. Nicholas took the infant from the waters and placed him in the Church of the Holy Wisdom before his icon. In the morning, the infant was found alive. It is impossible to enumerate all the miracles of St. Nicholas. He is the patron of travelers, and we pray to him for deliverance from floods, poverty, or any misfortunes. He has promised to help those who remember his parents. When St. Nicholas peacefully fell asleep in the Lord, his relics were preserved incorrupt and flowed with myrrh, from which many received healing. In 1087, his relics were transferred to Bari, Italy, where they rest today in the Roman Catholic Basilica of St. Nicholas. Other remains of the relics are found in Russia, Greece, and Romania, and St. Nicholas is known throughout the world.